what we have done, we have downloaded the Zotero and installed in my machine. So basically I have already downloaded it because I am already using this software. So just this session we will discuss about some of the features of Zotero reference management software. So first we will start from this side. So basically what happens when you install Zotero, you get a particular database that is called My Library. This is by default, and in the library you can create some sub collections. For example, here I have created a lot of collections already. So we create a sub collection. Even you can create a sub collection. For example, if it is My Library, I just want to create a collection, say MLIS demo. So what happens that whenever you add one item, that item is added in your library, and if you add it in a particular collection, then it is also added in, also shown in your collection. So for example, now I have created a collection called MLIS demo in My Library. So whatever I add in my MLIS demo collection, it will automatically be added in My Library. Okay. So now this side, if you see, this is one search box. So whatever the items that are available, that can be searched from here. So we will see different approaches. And here you can see that if you are already logged in, and if you create one account on Zotero.org, it gives you some 300-500 MB space on cloud. So whatever, if you till 300-500 MB space of documents, you can sync it with the Zotero cloud also. So you need on your different installations of Zotero, for example, if you have on your laptop and then in your PC also, if you want to have the same documents, then in that case you can integrate it with the cloud version so that on several devices the files will be synced. So because I am just using on my system, so there is no need for this much, and it is 300 MB, so for me it is my all files are more than some 1 GB, so 300 MB is not sufficient for me. But for a small project you can use this facility also. So right now it is synced with Zotero, and basic details are always synced on Zotero. I will show you how you can look at it on the Zotero web also. Now, so moving on to slide, what is first we will see the interface of the Zotero, and then we will also see how to capture from the article page and bibliographic databases, and then importing files, and we will also see how PDF files can be added, and then manual creation. So first let us start with, for example, I want to search something on Google Scholar, and then from there I want to add some documents. So I go to Google Scholar, I have opened the Google Scholar, and here, say for example, I search for collection development and also I want to search for library. Okay, so I have got some hits here, and you see the first hit is for book, and it is then second is a citation. Citation means there are no records found in a particular database, but people have cited this database. And third one is a link to a particular article, and also PDF is also available for this article. And key issues for e-resource collection, this is again a book, but a PDF is also available for this, and similarly for other, these ones are available. So for example, I am interested in only this one. So what you see here, when you install Zotero, it will ask you to install integration for, see here, for tools. And then in the not to edits preferences, and when you install it, it will ask you to install the connectors for your browser also. So what you have to do, you have to install two things. First is that is Zotero, and then you have to also install, I'll show you from here, zotero.org. So once you go to zotero.org, you download your Zotero from here. And also you see here, this is the interface of Zotero, and then collect with a click option, and then like from many of the databases you can directly with a click also you can organize it in your way that I was telling, like you can create a sub collection, sub collections and like that, and then you can cite it, stay in sync, that also I have, and you can collaborate also quickly by using Zotero groups and other things. So if you go to download section, and there you will find, yeah, you will find two things to download. You have to download the Zotero for Windows or particular operating system you have. For example, if you have Linux or Mac OS, whatever operating system you have, you will download the binary for the particular operating system, and also you will download a connector for your browser. So for example here, you by default, because I am looking from using Google Chrome, so it shows by default me shows to me the Zotero Google Chrome connector, as well as there are other connectors also for Firefox, also for Safari also. So whatever connect the browser you have, you download the relevant connector. So I have already downloaded, and this is the connector that already installed. Once it is installed, it icon will be appear as like other connectors. So now you see here the icon is now changed. It is somewhat more like a folder. So if I click on this folder, it will show me all the hits that are received on this page of Google Scholar. And as I said, I am interested in this one and this one. Only two articles I am just interested at present, maybe relevant for me. And then I click OK. So what happens? It saves just with one click. It saves the records in the Zotero library. You see here now, if I go to Zotero and see here, two items have been added. And also what it does, it looks for the PDF also and tries to find the PDF also. So here you see collection evaluation in one PDF was there, and for this one collection development policy, since the PDF was not available, so the PDF could not be retrieved. Okay. So now you see I have the PDF also with me. If I click on it, I with my browser I can see the PDF file. Similarly for the other one also, the PDF has been retrieved by automatically. I do not have to click on this and download the file and add it to Zotero like that. But that is also another way to do that. For example, if I want to download this file, I'll click on this and directly I can click on this and save to Zotero. Directly I can click and add save to Zotero. This also will save it to the Zotero. So this file is now available. I can just so let it load. Anyway, we do not have to do much on this. So now if you see, if I select one particular item, so these are items. So in the first item, you see automatically it has detected it is a journal, the title, the authors, it has two authors. Sometimes it also detects the author abstract also, but in this case it is not able to. Sometimes it detects, it depends on how well the particular database is designed. and then journal name, that is the collection building, then volume, issue, page number, date, and DOI also it has detected, short title and the library catalog, that is the database from where it is downloaded, and other details like extra publisher, date added, date modified, on which date. So all these details are automatically captured by Zotero. So you need not to, you just check it. If you want, you can just check it whether it is properly formatted or not, and then this is over. You need not to worry about it. Okay. So once the items are added, you can search them by using any of the search terms from the drop down. You can select whether you want to search only in the title creator here, or all fields and all tags and everything. In everything, everything covers. So for example, if I want just in the title creator and year, so I can, I just, for example, I want, I am just focusing on universities. So only the article which are having universe term in the title are only displayed, title or in the author field, it is only displayed. So I can restrict them. Similarly, for each item, there are some feature of tags also. Like for example, if for example this article is important for my, say, discussion section. So I can add a tag here. So just a tag added. And also it is also useful for me for introduction section. So I am just adding another tag, introduction. Similarly, I can also link related articles with this art, with this particular item. So for example, this is the article that I am looking, and another article that is of relevance for me, that also I can add. So the tags, when once we add the tags are visible here. So by clicking on a particular tag, I can limit the results here. So for example, I am just interested in all the articles which I have tagged with introduction. So I'll click on this, only those article, those items which I have tagged with introduction, it will be visible here. So just I have to read them and cite them in my literature. I'll show you how to do that also. So this is one way to add the items. Another way is to add items. I'll show you that this is one of the through databases. Also another database is there, that is called EBSCOhost. This one is little. So for example, here if I want to search for articles related to information retrieval, say information retrieval systems, I want to search for the articles. So this is one database, and here also if you see, the folder is changed. Okay, the icon is changed, now it has a folder view. So from here also if I click, I'll get all the results and I can add. Another approach is that that because this particular database provides me option to click or download, select the articles, inbuilt option. So I am just clicking, say for example, these two articles I am interested. Now if I go to folders here in this one, these two articles are there. Now I can export the file, export this information in, see here, direct export in RIS format, like Citavi, EasyBib, EndNotePro, and Zotero. So this one is for interest for me. So I just click this one and save. What will happen? So it is saying that because already a Zotero connector, it has detected that you can use automatic file import, and then if I click OK, whatever the articles I have listed in this, they are already available in my, now added to my added to my Zotero library, whatever I have selected at present. So you see, these two articles will be added here. So that is one way. Another way, and then for example, I just want somewhere I got a link for a particular article, and I just want to add that particular article to my Zotero reference list. Say for example, this is one article that is recently published on 14th April, and I am interested in this article. Now this article is PDF, which means that I have access to this article. It is a free access one, and I have access to this article. So you see the icon is now changed to article icon, and if I click on this, it will capture the article as well as its full text. So if I go back and see here, now the article is already added as well as its file is also available, that is the full text is also available with me. So this is one way that we can also add the articles. Similarly, for example, I have another article, or from somewhere I have got an article whose DOI is available with me. DOI, you might be aware like what is DOI, but say for example DOI is available with me. So with DOI also I can add. I have to click here and I'll paste the DOI here and press enter. So what it will do, it will search, go on internet and find the particular article details, and then also try to fetch if the PDF access is available to me. It will be fetched and attached to a particular entry in the database. So you see it has already downloaded the PDF also. So I need not to worry about all these details like how to download and how to feed the information. So this has four authors, and already it has captured the four authors, the publication, the volume, issue and other details. Say for example, volume, issue and other details are not available, then you can check it and then put it in this one also. Okay, so this is how we add. Another way is that if, say for example, I have one PDF files or bunch of PDF files with me, and I want to add those PDF files in my Zotero collection. So for example, this is one article PDF that is already with me, and I want to add, just I am dragging it and dropping it in my collection, and in some fraction of seconds the particular document will be added, as well as it will try to fetch the metadata, that is the title, author, details of this particular article, and then it will create the entry also. See here, just I have added the PDF file and it has created the title and author's name and the journal in which it was published, volume number, everything it has captured from internet and brought it and saved it in my Zotero library. So you see how it saves a lot of time of the researchers. And once this collection is with me, I can share it with the others also. I can export this collection as a file and I can share it to somebody. I can create bibliography from this collection itself. I can generate reports. Say for example, if you want your guide to look at your articles, you can just click on generate report from this article. It will create a file with all the details, notes, everything, abstract, everything it will create, and then you can print this file, and then you can do, if you like, you can do a review using paper also if you are more comfortable with that also. And there are a lot of other features also. So moving on to like another way, that is, this we have discussed already about capturing from article pages, that just now we have seen capturing from bibliographic databases like Google Scholar and EBSCOhost. We have seen downloading and importing as a files. This I will show you once again, but we have already seen it through PDF files. Just now I have added one PDF file, and we have seen that how it captures the metadata, brings the metadata from internet. And I'll show you this one, like how to download a file and then add it to Zotero. Say for example, this file is not properly added. So there is one button called download citation. If I click on it, it will ask me choose format. So RIS, because Zotero is already there. Zotero supports RIS format. It supports BibTeX also. And then I say download citations. What it will do, it will give me a RIS file, RIS file, and then I am downloading this file, RIS file. And now I am going to Zotero, and here in the file I click import, and in the import it asks which type of file you want to import. So I said F file, and then it will ask the location of the file. So I just download it in the downloads, this one RIS file, and I click next. Then it says place imported collections and items into new collection. I said no, copy files to the storage folder. And this is one thing, like if there are files also, whether you want to copy to your folders or not, so that is not important. So I have just copied and finish. So if I say date wise, if I arranged, or here also I can say recently added, there is one menu. Unfiled items. Anyway, so what it does that it you can directly include that particular article in your collection by this method. Another way is you go to the downloads folder and drag and drop this file here, so it will be added as a RIS file. No, we do not want this. So I'll just delete this. So what is the problem that is happening, that when we are adding it, it is basically adding to the my collection. So best way is that what we do, we create a collection of imported this one, and then we delete that collection after copying. Place imported in one collection, finished. So in this collection it has copied. So what we do, we copy this item from this collection to our required collection. So now what do websites, this is now, you see two are already there. So means one which we had earlier imported, and this is the one which we just now imported. Now we have just copied, we can remove, delete this collection, delete, we have deleted this collection. So now if you see here, I have option that we have already seen that lot of items have been added, and we have seen different approaches. Say for example, at some moment the Zotero is not able to capture, so what you do not have any option, so you have to do manual entry. So here if you click on plus one, you select newspaper journal article, or usually for the case of, say for example, newspaper article or something, for journals etc, it will automatically detect, no problem at all. But usually what happens for websites and others, there will be some problem. So here we can add the title manually, say for example the last name of the author. Robert Frost. And publication, say for example XYZ Journal. And volume, say 32 issue, second, and date, say 2018. So So this way we have added one entry manually to this one, and now we can add attachment. It can be a link to a uniform resource identifier, or it can be a stored copy of the file or link to file. So if you select stored copy of the file, then it will ask you to which file you want to connect with this particular this one. So this way you can add items in the collection, and once the items are added, there are other ways also, like you can create notes also for each item. Just for example, if I have read this article and I want to create some notes so that tomorrow I will be able to you already notes will be there while writing this one. So you can create add, and then you can just directly this paper discusses about managing websites, so it will be automatically stored on clouds, and you can also use hashes here, check for example important for literature review section, like that. So it will be saved here in the as along with the item. Whatever the notes we are creating, all the items will be stored along with the items. So next is that I will tell you how, once you have collected the references, now I will show you how to cite them. So for this we have to install what it does, that at the time of installation itself, it will install the plugins for the see here I was telling the tools install browser connector. So from here you can also install, as well as from the edit preferences you can install the word processor. In the word processor tab you can see in the Microsoft Word add-in is not currently installed, install Microsoft Word add-in is not currently installed, install LibreOffice add-in. So actually it is installed but it doesn't know, so let it be like that. So already you see in my Word I already have installed the plugin, Microsoft Word plugin, and here you see there is one tab called Zotero, and in this tab I have some options. This I will show you how to use them. So for example, I am writing one article, and in this article I just, for example, just I am telling this is the title of the title and abstract. So I am just writing something, for example introduction section, and here I want to add a citation, in-text citation. So the research in the field of collection development has varied interest among the scholars. Now here I want to cite a particular author name, and I want to specify which work he has done. So I'll click on add edit citation button. So at the first time when I click on add edit citation button, it will ask which particular citation style you want to use to cite the references in this particular document. So that is document preferences. I have to specify the preferences. So a lot of that citation styles are supported in Zotero. For example, you see American Psychological Association is there, Chicago Manual of Style is there, Elsevier, Harvard is there, IEEE is there, MLA is there, Nature and Vancouver style. So almost all the styles are by default supported. But if there is something specific, you can also search. There is one website of Zotero where you can download these styles also. So that is out of scope for our this one. So I am just selecting APA, that is the American Psychological Association 7th edition style for this document. And then my language of the document is English. I have selected and then click OK. So now a small pop-up window will appear, from where I have to select which particular article I want to cite. So for example, I want to cite this Mosher article, this Mosher guy, and if you want, you can suppress the author name. ठीक है. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन माई केस आई एम स्टार्टिंग अ पैराग्राफ, सो आई नीड टू सप्रेस द ऑथर नेम, बट ओनली द ईयर विल बी डिस्प्लेड. सो आई क्लिक ओके. सो सी, यू सी हियर ऑटोमेटिकली इट हैज एडेड द ईयर. सो इफ यू क्लिक ऑन दिस, इट विल शो अ फील्ड नोट. Field note means that there is something in the background, some code is running. Studied something, blah blah, you are writing, and then you want to mention, you want to cite another paper. So another, again I click on this, and this time I want to cite this paper, and I do not want to suppress the author. So it will automatically design the in-text citation as it is required in American Psychological Association. So this is how you cite documents when you are writing with Microsoft Word, as well as your Zotero is connected. Now in between also, if you want to change document preferences, you can change and unlink citation. These are not much important, but later you, in detail you can also, if you really use this software, then you can also explore these features. Now say for example my paper is over, and here I want to include the references. So what I have to do, I have to select add edit bibliography option, add bibliography option, the second one. So once I select add bibliography, what it does, that it matches what are the different articles that are cited by the author in the text, and then accordingly those items, bibliographic record items, are displayed as per the chosen citation style. So jaise abhi maine, I have chosen American Psychological Association, so the string is modified as per the American Psychological Association. So this is the way we can create easily the citation reference list, as well as we can cite. So there is another case I will like to discuss with you. Say for example I sent one paper to one journal where APA citation was recommended, and I created this document with APA citation. Now what happened, they rejected my paper. That is very common in academia, you get your papers rejected. So I tried to submit it in another journal, but that journal supports Chicago Manual of Style. So what to do? In earlier model, if you are not using this software, what you have to do, you have to again go to the text and change each citation one by one as per Chicago. But here you have to go to document preferences, go to Chicago Manual of Style and click OK. So what happens, it changes the whole, wherever you have used the citations, it changes the citations. You see, in APA we use ampersand, but in Chicago we use after author name we use comma in APA, but here we do not use comma. Similarly, the APA citation, the double line is used, whereas in here the lining is different, as well as the way it is written is also different. So likewise, you can also change in one click only the whole citations, the whole reference list of your paper. So that saves a lot of time. Say for example tomorrow some paper, and this also got rejected, and that guy said no, I want a type of nature this one. So what it does, in nature you have the superscript model, where you put the references as superscript. So it automatically converts them into superscripts, and the reference list also now arranged numerically by the way the order in which the citations are made in the text. So likewise, with just a single click, you can change the whole citation, in-text citation, as well as the reference list also. Now you must have understood that what is basically Zotero reference management software. There are other features also, but I will not go in detail. I have told you the minimum basic of all the Zotero reference management software. Like you can import, export your library, whole library, and you can share it with others. Another feature that we can create is you can create a new group also. If you want to share a particular some documents with somebody else, you can create a group, and it will lead you to the website where you can create a group. And then you in the group, so for example here I have created and I belong to some groups. So in this group, say for example I want to add a particular document, I can just drag and drop this document in the particular group, and it will be added, it will be visible to the all the members of that particular group. Similarly, you can follow the groups on internet also. There are several group libraries which are available, and you can follow them also. You can get the results directly. You can get the items which are shared by others. So in this way you can discover new items, you can find new items which are available. So I hope that the things are more clear, and you can manage your citations references in detail. There are a lot of add-ons also available in Zotero that can help you in that can help you in minimizing the other works that are available in Zotero. And also just I wanted to show one of the best features that in Google Docs also it is supported. So that is another feature, best feature. That's why I use Zotero. I do not use Mendeley and other software, because in Zotero you can directly cite documents in Google Docs also. For example, I created a Google Doc, and here you see there is a menu called Zotero, and in this just I click on it will again ask me for the document preferences. Let it load. So I'm on a slow network, but here you get the options where you can select the like document preferences, and directly from here you can add the citation. So that is another feature of Google Docs that is Zotero that is very useful if you are collaborating with other authors that are sitting somewhere at different places. So I'll stop here, and if you have any doubts you can comment in this thread which I create, and also you can comment in make your queries in written form also, and send it to me on my email ID also.